My dear friends, from the book of Acts chapter 20 verse 28 onwards, we have heard the word of God. In verse 28, St. Paul clearly teaches us, guard yourself. He says, guard yourself, and whom God has entrusted to you. Guard yourself. And there are certain precious things God has given to you. And he says, why we should guard them? Because they are purchased by his blood. He has paid the price, and he has earned you and me and our families and our church, and he has given to us. Yes. As God has made us to be guardian and shepherd. So he tells each one of us that God has made each one of us a shepherd and a guardian. We have to guard it and we have to shepherd it. And which he has done with his own blood. He says, be aware of your call. And be aware of your mission. Two things he says. I have given you a call. And I have desired you to have a life of mission. What is that call? He says the call of God is that you are chosen by God to be a guardian and shepherd. A guardian and shepherd has to be very, very careful. A great work God has trusted us. And what is our mission of life? To guard ourselves, our church, our family, and so on. Verse 31, he says, watch out. It's not enough just to hear that God has a call for you. And God wants your life to be in such a way, a mission of your life. He says you have to watch out, because there are many elements in the world. They are coming to with a distort message to destroy my call and the life of mission that I have given to you. What is my call and my mission of life? He says in chapter 20 verse 32, he says, guard the message of grace that I have taught to you through Jesus Christ. What is the message of grace? Which we read in Romans chapter 5:7-8. Maybe a good man may die for another good man. But while we are still sinners, Jesus died for us and proved his love for us. The salvation we have received is not ours. We have not worked for it. But he has given to us freely. That's what he repeated in John chapter 3 verse 16. God so loved the world, he sent his only son, that not a single one should perish, but everyone should have life. So it's the grace, it's not ours. We have not worked for it. God has given us this grace to be saved by his love. And we should remember this message always. And what is the mission of life he has given to us? He says, you have received now salvation freely. Now you need to crucify yourself along with Jesus and live the life he has desired for you. Not to live as you desire. He loved you and gave his life for you. Though it is not your due. Though you have not done anything. It is mere grace. He died for you. Now you don't learn to live for yourself. But to crucify yourself. As he says in Galatians 2:20. He says, it's no longer I live. I crucify myself with God. and I live the life by the one who has loved me and gave his life for me. Yes. So the Lord says clearly, remember always that your life is given. Now you need to learn to give yourself to God. Your life has many possibilities. You can do this, you can do that, you can do this, you can do that. Plenty of things you can do with your intelligence, with your talents, with your family background, with your money. You can do many things. But don't forget, I have called you for a particular way of life. What is that? You have received the message of grace. So now you crucify yourself with God. And that's what he said in Matthew 16:25. He said, he who tries to save himself, tries to build up his life, his career without the mission of God, they will lose their life. But he who loses himself, Lord, my life is yours. And here I am giving my life to you. They will continue to have life. That's why St. Paul says in verse 35, there is joy in giving than receiving. He says there are so many people who will try to do many things, try to take away your life, train you to do many things in the world. Remember my grace, the message of my grace. While you are still sinner, I died for you. I gave you salvation, though you don't deserve it. It's a free gift for you. Number two, now live your life as a gift for God. I heard a story. A boy was entrusted by a man, good man, and gave 100 eggs and told him, okay, you can sell in different shops and I will give you the profit and you can have a living. You don't have a job. And the boy was with a great joy with this good man who entrusted him with 100 eggs with the different boxes, carrying, putting them in the cycle. And he was going, young boy. And another mischief boy, he also came. Something happened. This boy with the eggs, he fell down on the road. All the eggs fell down. In this world, all kinds of people are there. One fellow saw and he took his message for camera. He took the picture and he put the message. There is omelette in the road. The world is world. But this boy was crying and kept his hand on the head. Why these things have happened to me? I just started a new business. So many people came. They were standing. They were feeling so miserable. Some are feeling empathy, sympathy. All those things will not work. Suddenly one man came with a scooter. He kept his scooter side and he saw and the boy sitting, the eggs are fallen. He tapped his shoulder, looked at that boy. Don't worry. In life, these things happen. Take courage. He took 100 rupees from his pocket, put into his hand. This is my share. Don't worry. Get up. And went away. All the other people, they saw. They also got wisdom now. So they gave 50 rupees, 20 rupees. Totally 1,250 rupees came. The eggs are only 1,000 rupees. And last one man came, old man. He took 20 rupees and gave it to him and said, son, I am watching all that is happening. Don't forget that old man, like me, one more fellow came first and gave you 100 rupees and made an atmosphere for everybody to do good to you. In spite of your mistake, you should have been careful. But that man was so kind and gave an atmosphere whereby everybody could help you. He is the owner of your life. He is the man to whom you should be grateful to. That boy said, that man is my owner. He could have given to slaps, you destroyed, I trusted you and gave you. No. Knowing everything what has happened, he gave an another opportunity. Don't worry. Take courage. Everybody makes mistakes. Get up. This is my share. Not only he lost everything, he gives another investment. There are many good people in the world. Knowing all of us try to do good to us, maybe they can do only to a level. But our Savior, knowing everything of us, he forgave us and gave us his very life. That is the message of grace. We should never forget. And that old man said, live a life and prove through your life it is worth that your owner, knowing that he lost all his 1,000 rupees of egg, still he gave another 100 rupees. Now you start new life and prove to that man it is worth that he trusts you. Yes, that is the mission God gives to us. I know you are dying in your sin. I gave my son who shed his blood, died a horrible death, to forgive your sins, to show you his love for you, though you don't deserve. And now live out your life in such a way by giving yourself on the cross and live a life that is worth. Prove through your life it is worth that he trusted you and gave you this life. He called you. So we are given the message of grace and invited us to live a life according to the trust he has placed upon us. We should not forget our God, who, knowing all our sinfulness, still has accepted us as we are. Instead of punishing us for our mistakes, rather giving us an again new opportunity, we should learn to give ourselves and prove to the world through our life it is worth that he has saved us. That's what in today's gospel Jesus says in John chapter 17 verse 11. Jesus prays for our protection from all the evil ones. They are roaring like a lion, trying to disturb our mind. And what do? They take away our call. Once the call is gone, how will we live our life to God? Our mission will go away. So he says, God, your call. Day and night remember what Christ has done for you. Day and night remember the message of grace. The word of God is entrusted to you. Yes. And live your life as God has dreamt for you. Through your life you prove it is worth living. Close your eyes for a minute. Be in the presence of the Lord. The Lord is coming to us with a message of grace and inviting us. Dying on the cross is the message of salvation. And when you crucify yourself with the cross and live a life that God demands from you, it is your life for God. Let God guide us. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We will live a life that is pleasing to you, Lord. Thank you, Father.